Hey folks, this is Burke Holland, and in this video, we're going to take a look at some demos of using comments or code comments in JavaScript. So code comments in JavaScript are just lines of code that are not executed by the JavaScript runtime. So in this example here, we have a simple console log that we can run with a node index.js, and it will write out what the value of that is. Now there's two types of code comments in JavaScript. There's single line comments and multi-line comments. So to comment out this line here, I can put two slashes in front of it, and you'll notice that the editor changes it to a gray color. And that's how we know that the line is commented out. And if we run this again, there's no output because the runtime is now just ignoring this code. Now, why would you want to use comments? I mean, several reasons. One of them might be to just add in some context that is necessary for the reader to know about the code. So for instance, the connection string here is found in local.settings.json. Even though we don't have a connection string, maybe we pretend to have one in there. Another one might be to add a to-do for yourself. As you're coding, you might want to remind yourself and say to-do, and then come back and say add in database connection string. The nice thing about this is that in an editor, you can search for all to-dos like this with a search menu. Most editors have this, and you can find all your to-dos, and there's even some extensions in VS Code to help with that as well. And then lastly, a lot of times you just use it to comment out a line of code that you don't want to run, but you don't want to delete it either. You'll do this a lot when you're developing. Now, the other type of code comment in JavaScript is the multi-line comment. Now, multi-line comments start with a slash and then a star, and they end with a star and then a slash. And anything in between, even on the same line or the next line, all the way up until that last star slash is commented out. So for instance, if we took this here and we moved it down here to the bottom, all of this is now commented out, but this line would not be commented out. This line would still work. Now, it's important to note that in most editors, there is a baked-in functionality that allows you to quickly comment lines on and off. In Visual Studio Code, that's Command or Control and then the slash. And what that does is it just comments a line out. And if I hit it again, it uncomments it. Now, this is important to note because it also works on blocks. So if you highlight a block and then do it, the whole block is commented out. And notice that it puts the slashes on every single line. So you'll use multi-line comments less than you think you will because of this editor capability that will automatically put the slashes there and then take them off for you. So you don't really care about how many slashes are on each line because you're not the one fooling with that, the editor is. Now it's important to talk about when you should use code comments. In this example here, we have a block of code that reverses a string. And there's a comment up top that says this code reverses a string. Now when you first start developing, you're gonna feel this pressure to explain all of your code and what it does. And you should try not to do that. Too many comments in your code makes your code harder to read, believe it or not. What you want to do instead is write code that's simple enough that any JavaScript developer could come along later and understand what it does. And remember, you're the JavaScript developer that's going to come along later, so write it for yourself. Keep yourself in mind. Now, one of the ways that you can do that, there's a lot of ways, but one of the ways is to just take blocks of code like this that need an explanation and turn them into a function. So if we take this code out, instead we might have a block of code here where we've wrapped it in a function called reverse string. And then instead of adding a comment, the next developer that comes through here and looks at this code, which remember is probably going to be you, can see, oh, this reverses the string. And of course, this code runs as well as the other code did. I'll just run it here just to prove it. There we go. And in this way, this code is self-documenting. Doesn't need any comments. It explains what it does with the function name. So that's it. Single line comments, multi-line comments. And remember, if you can, make your code self-documenting. Use comments sparingly.